Inside the Pediatric Infusion Center at UC Davis Health, a new medication arrives. Along with it, a buzz of excitement.
Shall we go and deliver it to the nurse?
The Rodriguez family had worried this day might never come, a day their five-year-old son could be potentially cured of a rare and deadly disease.
Ruby, it is here. Here are your first two syringes.
Andrew Rodriguez has Duchenne Muscular Dystrophy, a degenerative disease caused by a defective gene. DMD causes muscle wasting and weakness, taking away the ability to walk, move, even breathe. It affects boys almost exclusively. With complications like heart or breathing problems, most patients with DMD die in their 20s. The outlook for Andrew changes today with a revolutionary new treatment, a gene replacement therapy.
All right, buddy, it's starting.
With clinical translational medicine, we've really gone from basic science and the discovery of a defective gene and a defective protein to actually administering an infusion, an IV infusion, which actually replaces that defective gene with a functional gene.
Almost immediately following the FDA's approval of this new therapy for kids ages 4 to 6, Andrew is one of the first in the country to receive it. It's called Elevidys, a one-time infusion, just a 2-hour treatment, that seeks to stop a lifetime of severe disability. Next, DMD researchers, such as UC Davis Health's Dr. Craig McDonald, will enroll younger kids in a new clinical trial, the youngest kids in the world to receive the treatment. The goal? To expand the use of the drug and potentially save even more children from this deadly disease. Duchenne muscular dystrophy occurs when a protein in the body called dystrophin is unable to function properly. Dystrophin protects muscle cells from the injury that occurs with everyday use. But in DMD, the muscle breaks down and is replaced by connective tissue and fat. This occurs gradually over years. As children grow, their muscles turn weak.
Can you look at mom? Where's mom?
Symptoms can start as early as age 2 or 3.
Go, up as fast as you can, go, go, go.
Shortly thereafter, even just getting up off the floor can be difficult as the lower body loses strength, like we see in this 9-year-old patient.
Perfect. All right, standing, hands down.
Walking, running, and jumping are also affected. Some kids never develop these skills. Here's the same patient at age 17. The heart and major breathing muscles also begin to fail. This can lead to early death.
Historically, we've only been able to provide supportive care, perhaps slow the progression with provision of medications such as steroid medications, which have a host of side effects. But the new gene therapy actually replaces the defective dystrophin gene with a functional gene.
For decades, Dr. McDonald has devoted his career to finding an effective treatment and possibly a cure. He played a key role in designing the clinical trials for this gene replacement therapy at UC Davis Health.
The results in the trial were spectacular, particularly in the younger children of the trial who were 4 to 5 years of age. These children actually developed the ability to run normally, climb up stairs normally, climb up playground structures normally. This is a one and done treatment, so just a one-time infusion actually will produce the intended effects.
This newly functional gene can stop the disease from progressing and keep symptoms from getting worse. So the earlier the patient is able to get the treatment, the better the outcome. Elevidys is now approved by the FDA for ages 4 and up in kids who can still walk. For those who can't, insurance companies can approve the treatment on a case-by-case basis. Now, a new clinical trial will treat patients as young as 2 when symptoms first start to show. Dr. McDonald's team begins their search for the right toddler for the trial. More than 6,000 miles from Sacramento, in Hsinchu, Taiwan, Dino Kong and Emily Kuo welcomed a new arrival, their second son. His name is John. The family calls him John John. They were joyful to have what they thought was a healthy baby boy. That changed suddenly when the phone rang, the results of John John's newborn screening.
The nurse from the hospital called us that, actually, the CK level in his blood is really, really high, and highly likely that he has this genetic disease called Duchenne Muscular Dystrophy. Of course, this whole conversation is in Chinese, and I was like, what do you say? Can you repeat that name again? And then I Googled it, and it does draw a very bleak future for the child.
Phil pretty sad that his life like won't be longer than 30 years, and a lot of limitation in his life that he can't move around.
We just both cried on learning about this.
I'm trying to brace myself for like this child will die before I do, most likely, and he will probably never ever experience a normal life as a child, life as a teenager, life as a young adult, and probably nothing beyond that.
That phone call was 2 years ago. Now the family's sadness has turned to hopefulness. They heard from a friend at church about the clinical trials at UC Davis.
It changed the game for us, basically. Yeah, it's like, wow, so this is actually perhaps treatable.
Thanks to a work visa, Dino and Emily moved their family to Davis, California, and enrolled John in Dr. McDonald's clinical trial.
It's not an easy decision to begin with, like, uproot your family to somewhere like completely strange and starting from zero, basically.
The culture is really different from my really used to.
Starting a new life in a new country so their son can receive a new drug.
Oh yeah.
It's well worth it.
Yeah, it's worth it.
Yeah, right?
Yeah.
Because just so that he get to enjoy a future that he otherwise wouldn't have the chance to. Yeah, so, and that's, to me, that's like no brainer. If we have a chance for him, then I would do it. I'll do anything it takes.
Before John can receive his potentially life-saving treatment, the family brings him to UC Davis Health for what's called a baseline appointment. It's important for tracking his progress and ensuring safety for this two-year-old patient.
Baseline is a visit in which we're starting from ground zero. So everything that's collected for this patient at this visit, data, blood work, physical assessment, that is going to be the comparison point for all other assessments and visits that follow.
The next several hours are filled with tests to gauge John's abilities and ensure he's healthy enough to receive the therapy.
Can you put these in the bottle?
He'll be evaluated the same way after the treatment to measure any improvement.
Ooh.
How well he climbs stairs, runs down the hall, and picks up a ball are carefully documented.
Good job.
He takes a few spills along the way, but recovers. This appointment is a long one.
It's a lot for a little baby, but it's really necessary to make sure he's in the best state possible.
During the testing, Dino thinks about the two-year journey that brought them to this day.
It feels surreal. It feels surreal that, it's really happening. Everything we hope for, we pray for, fall into play exactly, and it was a plan, the best scenario. So I would say God is really good to us. God is really good to us.
If John is sick, the treatment may be delayed, so Dr. McDonald checks for anything out of the ordinary. John gets the green light. The infusion is scheduled to take place in 2 weeks.
Listening to your heart sounds great.
I'm really excited. I really am. I can't really describe it. But also at the same time, just being paranoid, thinking about, can there be like some other complication? So pretty excited, and I put those trivial thoughts and trivial words to God.
It's the day of John's infusion. For the care team, the day starts early. Preparing the infusion is the complicated first step in a carefully orchestrated day.
Ensuring patient safety is my number one goal when working on a clinical trial.
For such trials, the investigational pharmacy at UC Davis Health is dedicated to treatments that have not yet been approved by the FDA. The staff here will prepare John's personalized gene replacement therapy. The preparation takes hours. Across campus, John arrives at Dr. McDonald's office.
So once they come on site, we receive the prescription with all the information we need.
There we are.
And then we'll immediately go to the freezer and pull out the vials. There's a 2-hour thaw time. And so we'll set those out to thaw while we do the rest of the paperwork.
Time is very important. We make sure everything is scheduled on time. And we calculate that from the beginning to the end.
The treatment is contained in these 16 frozen vials. Manufacturer Sarepta delivered them a few weeks earlier. By sunrise, the vials are thawed. Pharmacy staffer Nadir transports them to a pharmaceutical clean room inside the hospital, a room free from contaminants to ensure drug safety. Keeping things sterile is critically important when preparing an infusion like this gene therapy. The pharmacy staff don several layers of gloves and gowns to avoid contaminating it. Properly attired, Nadir measures the exact amount of medication needed into large syringes.
We have to focus from the beginning to the end for the whole process to make sure we make it clean, sterilize, and safe.
After about an hour, he finishes the preparation and the pharmacy team gives the care team a heads up.
Rachel?
Yeah, I think it'll be ready about 8:15.
The syringes are readied for Dr. McDonald's team to pick up. Clinical research coordinator Rachel Beck hustles to the hospital, grabs the syringes, and dashes across campus to the UC Davis Research Infusion Center.
I feel like it's a lot of pressure because it's an important medication. It's been prepped for hours. So we grab it and we don't dilly-dally. We run straight for the infusion center and we make sure it's getting there straight away.
The syringes arrive, handed off like a relay baton, and the infusion team takes over. It's already been a long morning for this toddler. Parents Emily and Dino do their best to entertain him. The first syringe is loaded, and the gene replacement therapy begins. The treatment itself isn't painful, but it will require John to stay in bed until it's finished. Not easy for an active toddler.
As soon as they're getting infused, starting from the beginning, every 10 to 15 minutes, someone has to do exercises with him. It's to make sure all of his muscles, his joints, his body is moving so that the medication can get circulated through.
John is also monitored for any sort of negative drug reaction. One syringe down, three to go. John has been in this room for several hours now.
That's why the snacks come into play. That's why the toys come into play. And if they're two, of course, they're not gonna understand everything that's going on. So if they're like food motivated, it's gonna help them do the exercises.
Thank you. Good job.
We're trying to keep it entertaining by just giving the videos and just playing with them, messing around with them.
The infusion of syringe number two is complete. This is the halfway point. John settles in with some animal videos on YouTube as the third syringe is loaded.
So far, the infusion is going well. You know, he's only 2 years, a little over 2 years, so he's a little fearful, but the staff is doing a great job, and he's tolerating the infusion extremely well.
Time for snacks again as the fourth and final syringe is loaded.
You want to give Georgie a blueberry?
No?
2 stressful years and a journey to a new country, all for this moment.
This is it. This is it. This is the moment we've been praying for pretty much ever since the moment we know there's a potential for John to join this clinical trial.
That sound signals the end of the treatment. The treatment that could change the trajectory of John's life.
It's really quite rewarding, and I think that every time I treat one of these children, I'm moved by the experience.
John will stay with the team for a few more hours. They'll watch him to make sure he doesn't have any side effects. Inside of him, the defective DMD gene has been replaced. Now the wait begins to see if it worked. Months later, the family is back to see the team at UC Davis. It's time to run John through the same tests from his baseline evaluation to see how the results compare. Any improvements would be a great sign for the clinical trial and for John's future.
John is doing amazingly well. He is really showing normal ability to get up from the floor. He doesn't have to push off his knee because of hip weakness. He's actually able to begin to run, and he's running normally. We're seeing him go up and down stairs in a much more normal fashion.
Good job!
So really, I'm seeing John develop skills much more similar to a healthy, typically developing child.
These promising results echo those seen in older children.
The amazing aspect to me is just really how uneventful these infusions have been for the children. They have tolerated it and experienced it extremely well, and it's just spectacular just how rapid the improvement can be in these young patients that we're treating.
John's results provide valuable data for the clinical trial, and Dr. McDonald hopes will lead to a transformational improvement for patients with DMD.
It's just incredibly rewarding to be able to offer a patient like John and their family an effective treatment to really completely change the course of a devastating disease, and to just think that John is going to have a completely different future in terms of his ability to participate in school, to attend college, to maintain his function, his mobility, his quality of life, to ultimately have a family and pursue a career. It's just so gratifying to just think of the impact that our entire team has been able to have on a patient like John.
It's been a long journey for John, who's now 3 years old. His parents say they see improvement every day.
It's really exciting to see how he's been changing.
Yay! He's willing to try different things at the playground.
He's not that scared or reserved anymore. He's more like, oh, let's try this and try that and be more adventurous. Kind of indirectly make him more happy kid.
Come and get
the ball.
You go get it.
Even the therapist said, oh, it's he doesn't have any symptoms shows his DMD.
John's progress will continue to be monitored by Dr. McDonald and the UC Davis team. For his parents, a sigh of relief. Dino and Emily say now they can envision a full and healthy life for their son.
Just glad to see how things turned out just perfect well. So yeah, that's awesome.
Hi, I'm Gunja.
The participants in this clinical trial pave the way for future patients with Duchenne muscular dystrophy to receive this treatment, a promising step that many hope will lead to an eventual cure.
Just feeling happy for him that he can have better quality of life. That's one thing I really wish he can have it, and now he can have it.